straight ahead, girls.
We're gonna go on show in 1 minute, everybody.
Out! Everybody out! Anybody who's got a long
time. Be careful with the wires!
Move! Move! Move!
So please make it as hot, as up, as sexy, as energetic, and better than you've ever been.
I'm like all of you.
Girls, we're gonna go on stage now.
Wake them up!
I can't breathe.
The girls are inside the box right now.
I'm good.
Girls, let's go. Caroline, Alex, and Alex,
go.
You gonna start the show or what?
Special occasion. It is the 10th anniversary of the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show. It started off being a small show, but now it's been watched by more than 2 billion people.
The first show was rough in terms of the fashion, the hair, the makeup, the number of models that we got. We really didn't have a clue what we were doing. I mean, it was like, you know, hey kids, let's put on a play.
This was the first time really that the catalog and the stores came to life.
The show got worldwide press. They called it the lingerie event of the century.
You know, we were thinking of ways to make the show bigger and better, so we came up with the Million Dollar Bra. Every year, we've had a major supermodel and a major fantasy bra.
You know, it was really between 1996 and 98 that the show started to take on a life of its own. So we started to look for ways to expand the audience.
And what better way to do it than with the internet? In 1999, Victoria's Secret was the first ever fashion show to go live online around the world.
Live cyber fashion, reportedly the biggest internet event ever.
It was the most visited webcast of any kind in history.
So many people logged on that it crashed the web.
And we'd essentially turned the web to sludge.
They're simulcasting it in Times Square, so you could just stick your head out the window and see what the buzz is like. It's fabulous.
That's what I call stopping traffic. The 2000 show was also broadcast online. That year we went to the Cannes Film Festival in France. Victoria's Secret raised more than $3.5 million that year for an AIDS charity.
The lingerie giant is drawing more attention than some big-name movie studios. Even the models themselves are being photographed more than some of the Hollywood superstars.
It was no longer about the film festival. It was, how are we going to get in to see the Victoria's Secret show?
The U.S. Treasury Secretary said billions of dollars were lost in American productivity during the time that that show was on. If we could draw 1.2 million people to a webcast, then I thought certainly we could draw them to a television set. We began to understand the show had to be a lot more than just the girls walking down the runway.
Victoria's Secret is not really a fashion show, it's more like a show. So it's fun to go and, like, you're always gonna wear some funky outfits, you know, like, that you would never be wearing in real life. You know, this is what is like, it's more like a cabaret experience, like Broadway show or something.
And every year they say to us, what are you gonna do next year? Like, this was over the top, how could you possibly come back and do something bigger? And we do.
Don't go anywhere. The Victoria's Secret Fashion Show continues right here on CBS.